Yo guys, what's up? It's Redline bringing a new video today. Today's video is on Modern Warfare. We're playing CDL playlist. I can't believe I picked that guy after getting stunned like that. But basically what I'm doing today is some CDL playlists. Gonna talk about a little bit of the state of Modern Warfare, the CDL League, and some other things about me. So hopefully you'll hit that like, subscribe, and we're gonna go ahead and get right into it. Ooh, read them plays. Let's play it! Yo, guys, what's up? I'm playing some CDL playlists, S&D. We're playing Modern Warfare, if you haven't noticed. I don't know what's up with the red dot. You'll see me, like, sometimes I'll switch. Like, I'll run red dot or iron sights on the M4 here. I don't know. I guess it's a comfort level thing. I'm not exactly sure. And it's not even comfort, because, like, I play both of them, and I play both of them well at times. So I guess it's just, like, a switch up thing. Well, I guess... get beamed. Get beamed! I guess we can talk about that. Well, you know what? I'll just dive into everything about this video. So what this video is going to be about, and it's like a refresher course. For those of you who have never watched my videos before, or you're here for my Modern Warfare content only, or if you're like just stumbling upon this video and maybe you want to become a new fan or something, whatever. I'll give you a little bit of backstory about me, a little bit about what's going on and this game title and all that stuff, and meanwhile, we'll be having some... decent Search and Destroy gameplay in the background. I guess for this game, it's good. You know what I mean? We'll talk about that too. So let's go right into it. I'm going to start out. A little bit of background about me. I've competed in Call of Duty for years. I used to actually compete at basically the professional level. It's not the same now. Now players are different. It's a lot different. Like, I'm going to be really honest. My peak doesn't measure up to the peak of some of the pros now. Because like back when my peak was... some of the pros that are still around now were literally the tippy top. These were guys that were like, okay, yeah, I probably could never beat in the first place. And so that's pretty crazy. I just got wrecked right there. I didn't know where he was. I thought he went in there. Guess not. But basically, the tippy top was like, you know, like your Karmas, your Crimsticks, your Clasters and stuff. The guys that are basically playing still. Guess I can't forget about Scum. But I played back then. I played basically Modern Warfare 3. I played Black Ops 2, which I thought Black Ops 2 was probably the greatest competitive game in all history. I played a little bit of Ghost, but I basically kind of like retired from going to events. I played AW, wanted to go to events, but ended up not going to events other than like local stuff and traveling a little bit for that, but like not much. Played a lot for that for like half a season, like our like 6 months, 7 months, and then basically stopped playing it. So I was busy with work and stuff. Then work kind of really played a lot into my life, so like I would have stints where I played Black Ops 3 for about 3 months straight, and then took like 2 months off, and then came back to it for a little bit, and then went back, like back and forth. And then same thing with Infinite Warfare. I played it for quite a while, then I stopped, then I played it for quite a while, then I stopped, then I played it for quite a while. It was just, like, back and forth. It was fun. But, then I didn't play World War II, and now I'm on this one. I didn't play World War II, did play some Black Ops 4. You'll see some of the videos on the channel and stuff like that, but I just didn't... I don't play at the competitive level anymore. I'm a little older, and so, in regards to that... that's just what my competitive career was. Like, there's a point where I was at my peak. I'm also old. Like, I'm 32 years old at the time of recording this. So, if you didn't want a little chronological understanding, that basically I retired at, like, 25. In a sense. Other than I still play some. And the craziest part about that is that I'm going to be rebooting. I'm about to start playing a league. No, it's the end of the game. Damn near in over. I'm going to be playing a league here next month. Starts next, starts actually not next month. It starts like in a week or so. But I'm going to be playing a league, a 3v3 search league for fun with some homies. And like one of the players I'm going to be playing with, I've been playing with since Black Ops 1. And yeah, since he was a kid. Now he's like an adult and has a kid. It's crazy. You're going to get to see some gameplay there. Again, I'm not very good. And I just got beamed right there, dude. That guy beamed me. Was that a growl? Yeah, probably. So, you'll get to see that. That'll be on the channel. There's going to be some 3v3s on there and stuff. We're going to be playing the league. Hopefully, I can shine a little bit, or I'm just going to be falling behind because I don't play that much. So that's what's going to happen. We'll see what happens. But other than that, let's hop right into the topic of the CDL. Let's talk about the state of the game. Let's talk about all that other stuff that I wanted to talk about. You got a little bit of lowdown on me. If you wanted to know anything more, comment down below. Maybe I'll make another video if it's a good topic or if anything like that. I don't know. Another thing I was going to say. If I wasn't playing, I was coaching teams. I was working on teams. I was working with things. So, like, I was always kind of involved for a long time, and that's why I consider saying it was retirement at the end of Ghosts, was because after that, I played for AW, and all the other games, but I didn't coach anybody. I wasn't involved in the pro scene. I wasn't going to events anymore other than, like, local stuff. So I wasn't, AW might have been where my retirement really was. Like, after AW, I really technically retired because I didn't even compete at, well... I guess I competed at one local in Black Ops 3 and won it, and then didn't play anymore. So, weird. Or no, maybe I got second at the Black Ops 3. I had a throwback tournament at the same time I got first at Black Ops 2. I can't remember. Or maybe it was third. I guess third. Whatever. It was still, I basically stopped competing. I played one event. It wasn't the greatest. I didn't do the best. Again, I don't play as much. Ooh, this is a great spot. Holy shit. I like this spot. This guy's... Ooh, got the moves, dude, and he's got the time. Oh, and he still gets the kill. Bruh! That was a spot. I might actually have to use that spot. Plan on the outside. Have somebody plan on the outside. You got a sniper overlooking this far back. Good luck defusing. But yeah, we're going to talk about the state of the game. Do that first before we go into the CDL. Or no, let's go to the CDL first, and then we'll talk about the state of the game because it'll mix in. This year, if you guys are new to Call of Duty, new to competitive... anything or any of that stuff, or just anything in general. CDL, Call of Duty League. It was the new reimagination of the league. Before, you used to be, we'll go chronologically. Back in the day, like Black Ops, Modern Warfare 3, Black Ops 2, you were allowed to go to events, even Ghosts. You were allowed to go to events no matter what the age you were. You'd have to have like a parental consent under a certain age or whatever, but you were allowed to go to events. Didn't matter who you were allowed to compete on a team. You could be a 13-year-old kid playing with a bunch of 18-year-olds or 25-year-olds, it doesn't matter. You'd be allowed to go to the event, and you'd be allowed to compete. They ended up having to change it because they're trying to make the more sponsor-friendly, more mature, and legal-like battles. I don't want to deal with all that stuff. So they ended up changing it to 18 years old. I think, was it AW? No, it was Black Ops 3. That's what it was. Yeah, so AW was still under 18, and it was Black Ops 3, they changed it. So, when they changed it, it was still, anybody could go. You were 18 years old, if you got a team together, you could go. There was open events, and then the teams that were in the in league would still get a spot in, like, playing in the final bracket, but you could still earn your way through, I think. Was it one of the years they made it where you couldn't earn your way through anymore? I can't remember. But I know that people were still going to events. And what they did this year was change it to a league model. They're trying to take after the NBA, the NFL, the NHL, whatever. You know, they switched from a pool of pretty much 24 top teams. I mean, normally they have the top, like, 8 teams. Or top, at least the top 5 are usually always the same top 5. Anybody could kind of squeak into that top 8 spot if they got hot, you know what I mean? They got on a streak. Got beamed again! They go on a streak in open bracket. They could have gotten through. They could have gone all the way through. Like, I've seen streaks. Like, we even saw streaks where players went all the way through open bracket and got, what, third? Like, I think it was... Who was it? Or was it third or fourth? It was, Jordan General's team. Which I'm going to have that topic too. That's going to be a different one. Who's on the Huntsman, by the way? Where you see the Huntsman logo right now on this dude's thing. But he was the captain of Enigma 6. It was his team. And they made it through. Was it Advanced Warfare? Yeah, I think it was Advanced Warfare. UMG Orlando, which is like, not Orlando, Florida. I think it was, is that what it was? Orlando, is that what it's called? Over in California, I don't know, whatever. All I know is that People could make it through. They could get through hot. Like, and you'd be like, wow, I didn't expect this team to all make it all the way through. You know what I mean? And so, like, what I'm saying is we took a talent pool of these top 24 players or teams that had players that were even, like, just top caliber. Even a 24th place team could have one guy that could easily be on the top eight. You know what I mean? He just didn't, the team he's surrounded with or the opportunity wasn't given. So they shove all of these badass players into 60 players on 12 teams. But now imagine how much the competitiveness has gone through the roof. But also, now imagine the turmoil if you're not doing well. If you're not doing well, there's a lot of other players out there that can take your spot now. There's not like one or two before where you're like, I'm on this team because I'm solidified because I've been around for a while. Dude, you have the opportunity to be replaced real quick now. Like, and what happened was leagues have a salary. Some players, they have five guys, and then they have two subs guaranteed, unless you're like Toronto Ultra, where you have like 47 subs and you decided that your whole team is going to be like 15 different iterations throughout the season. Not making fun of Toronto Ultra. I thought that was actually kind of cool. That was actually smart. I thought it was good because you have a whole nother team, basically. Imagine practicing them against each other and you're like, dude, I'm going to pick the pluck the best, you know, of each one. But basically, in other English, beam. In other English, though, what I'm saying is that they created a league, 12 teams, supposed to be like the NBA. Nobody else is going in. They have an open bracket league for amateurs, which was a really nice thing for them to do, because I'm not going to lie to you, they didn't have to do that. It's been like that forever, so it's kind of traditional. It's something that makes our thing different. It gives us a farm league to go to, which is actually probably one of the smartest things Activision ever did. But, so, as for the CDL, that's cool. We have teams from everywhere. Chicago Huntsman, like I was talking about, Jordan General, is a substitute who should be on a team. But, he didn't end up being on a team. And, you see my Mutineer sign? Because, I don't know why, but I've bought that when it came out. I never picked a team. Like, I don't have a favorite team right now. But I've had the Mutineers thing because I thought their logo was badass. And I guess it goes with the theme of me watching One Piece lately and other stuff like that. So, like, I thought that was awesome. So I'm like, okay, well, I got the Mutineers on my thing, and they're turning out to be a pretty damn sick team. So go Mutineers, dude. But now we're going to go to the state of the game. So as for the CDL, all these pro players are really good. The biggest problem is that's an aspect there, is the meta shift. There's players that are not playing that should be playing on teams. There's players that are sitting benched because the meta didn't benefit their team or their attitude, which like I said, you can lose your job on this. There's only 12 teams. Guys, somebody who would easily be on a top 24 team and continually playing at a major event is now sitting on a bench and is not able to play. Yes, gradually he's getting money still, like Gunless example, but like somebody that with a meta shift that could be useful. The meta didn't change for years, or the whole year, my bad, I'm saying years, the whole damn year. So like running four MP5s with an occasional flex and an M4 is not something we've ever done. I've seen Black Ops 2 where the meta shifted all year long. Like the beginning of it was like fouls and dual caps, and then it went to single cap, then it went to no cap, then it went to B23Rs, went to dual B23Rs. Secondary. Some people were using those as their gun. They were like, hey, let's walk around with a as their SMG. Like, hey, let's walk around with a what was it? The AN-94, and then have our caps out to break the hill, and then switch to the AN-94 to beam them when they're coming in. Like, it was different. And then it switched to the AM-8, and like, it was a different time. And this is gonna be, I don't know, dude. All I'm saying is that I was pretty happy with how this game came out, but the time to kill is really affects the game. Warzone is what carries this game. It's amazing. The maps on here are not competitive. Game is not competitive. The guns are really not that competitive. It doesn't really have competitive updates. It's not a terrible game, but it needs some work. So I'm hoping the future is going to be better. But one thing's for sure is we didn't get handed a great game for this season for the CDL to be starting out on, and they didn't get handed a great deal. COVID came out, and now champs are going to be online. If you guys want to hear anything more from me on my opinions on things on the channel, comment down below. Maybe I'll do another video. Until then, I hope you enjoyed the video. Hit that like, subscribe. Thank you for my rant. Peace.